Okay, guys, listen up. This is what we worked for all year, and now we're here. This is the big one. Here's where we separate the men from... Well, I think you know what I mean. It all comes down to your performance tonight. So let's not forget what got us here. I want to see some nice, tight patterns. Poise under pressure. Don't forget to smile. Make sure you check your equipment. If somebody gets in your way, run them over. If somebody gets in your face, bite it off. Now let's do it. Let's go. Come on.
Tonight, live from the Genesis Center in Gary, Indiana, it's Miss USA 2001, introducing 51 of the country's most beautiful women. And now, your captain, William Shatner.
Welcome to Miss USA 2001. You may have heard, I just got married. Thank you. To a woman right here in Indiana. Thank you. And let me tell you, this is one hell of a way to spend your honeymoon. This is the real Temptation Island, let me tell you. Here is tonight's challenge. 51 women, one crown. To kick off the night, performing their hit song, Crazy for This Girl, Evan and Jared.
Delegates, you gonna sing with us?
Thank you. Thank you, Evan and Chara. In case you're asking yourself, what do 51 women do together day and night for 2 weeks straight to get ready for this very night? A burning question for me as well. We're about to find out. Let's meet them and find out what they've been up to. The 51 delegates of Miss USA 2001. Just in case you'd like to get your hands on their outfits, they're dressed in exclusive designs by To The Max with shoes by Donald J. Pliner. Over the past 2 weeks, a separate panel of judges made our work easy for us. They narrowed down the competition from 51 to a select 10. And here they are. Deliberately in random order. The first of 10 is Oklahoma.
Courtney Amoretta Phillips is a cross-country runner studying theater and political science at Oklahoma City University.
The next we have Tennessee.
Lisa Tollett holds a degree in journalism from the University of Tennessee, where she was also a cheerleader.
Come join us, Georgia.
Tiffany Fallon is a former Atlanta Falcon cheerleader with a degree in sports management from Florida State University.
Step on down, Rhode Island.
Yanazi Alvarez is a dancer and choreographer. She earned a degree in social work from Rhode Island College.
Halfway there, Nevada.
Gina Giacinto is a former Radio City Rockette and currently is a weathercaster for KVNBC in Las Vegas.
Let us see. Oregon.
India Abuante is a student at the University of Oregon. She hopes to one day become a network news broadcaster.
Enter District of Columbia.
Leon Angus is a graduate of George Washington University and hopes to earn a PhD in chiropractic medicine.
Breathe, Texas.
Kandace Krueger is a senior at Texas A&M University. Her career goal is to work as a sports broadcaster.
Two places left. Michigan.
Kenya Howard holds 2 degrees from Michigan State University and currently works as a mechanical engineer.
And the 10th spot goes to Missouri.
Larissa Meek is a video production artist who enjoys all aspects of art. She holds a degree in animation.
The top 10. Now, let's meet the beautiful face behind the beautiful voice you've been hearing, the current Miss Universe, Lara Dutta.
Coming right up, swimsuits in a steel mill.
Playing host to 10 women can be a daunting task for one mortal man. To help me put it in perspective, let's go backstage to where all the action really is. Here, from the bold and the beautiful, and former Miss Teen USA, Vanessa Minnillo, and from Bamboozled and TV's In Living Color, Tommy Davidson.
Thanks, Bill. It's crazy back here. There's so much nervous energy and excitement, and to tell you what, I know what that's like.
Well, this is my first time at anything like this, and let me tell you something, this is a mind-blowing experience, man. Why would anyone want to put themselves through this?
Well, Tommy, it's a prestige being in this pageant. No matter who gets the crown, every single one of these girls is a winner.
Well, don't they just hate wearing those sashes like 24/7, dragging them around? I got to be
Tommy. The delegates are normal, everyday people.
Yo, hey, you guys take this thing too seriously. I'm serious.
Well, we have to, because tonight we have 2 major competitions, swimsuits and then evening gowns.
And then they're going to be grilled by all those judges, so you know that's tough.
Yeah, I don't envy the delegates on that one, but I know how truly exciting this night can be. And let me tell you, Tommy, if you have any questions, please do not hesitate just to ask.
Well, I basically have 6 questions.
All right, sure.
Where are the bikinis?
I got one answer. Boys.
It's time to kick off the first competition. A lot of fuss and controversy has been made about judging a woman by the way she looks in a bathing suit. Why? It's the dead of winter here in Gary, Indiana. So for the swimsuit competition, we had no choice but to go to the hottest place in town, the steel mill. K Camcoder's brand new processing facility. Let's meet the top 10 up close and very personal, starting with Oklahoma.
Oklahoma's Courtney Amoretta Phillips is a sophomore at Oklahoma City University, where she's a double major in theater and political science. This cross-country runner would love to become the first female governor of Oklahoma.
Tennessee's Lisa Tollett hosts Star TV for the WB with her twin sister, Lori. Lisa received a BS in journalism from the University of Tennessee. She hopes someday to create a show about politics aimed at teenagers. Coming up, more swimsuits and find out what Martha Stewart, Daniel Baldwin, and Dr. Drew have in common. Right here on CBS.
Live at Miss USA 2001. Let's be politically correct. This is not a pageant. It's a competition. These are not girls. They're delegates. These are not skimpy swimsuits. They are submergible marine attire. That said, here's Georgia.
Georgia's Tiffany Fallon earned a BS in sports management with minors in communication and business from Florida State University. This former Atlanta Falcon cheerleader currently works as a flight attendant, but someday hopes to make her mark in the movies.
You know, it takes a certain kind of person to sit back and judge. Seven of them have been chosen to determine the fate of the top 10 delegates. Let's meet them. The woman that continues to change the way we live, Martha Stewart. Film and TV star, Daniel Baldwin. From the hit series Oz and my fellow co-star from Miss Congeniality, Ernie Hudson. Star of the hit TV series Everybody Loves Raymond, Doris Robinson. MTV VJ, Ananda Lewis. Co-host of Love Live, Dr. Drew. TV host, journalist, and actress, Karen Duffin. How did Martha Stewart and one of the Baldwin brothers arrive at a consensus? It boggles the mind. Judges, remember your votes. We'll send one of these women away as Miss USA 2001. Do not abuse the power. There are no pardons here. Now let's continue the swimsuit competition with Rhode Island.
Rhode Island's Yanazi Alvarez holds a degree in social work from Rhode Island College and is working towards a second degree in elementary bilingual education. She is her state's official spokesperson for Literacy Volunteers of America.
You know, Tommy, the hardest part the delegates have is changing outfits. It all has to happen back here really, really quickly.
Well, so that's when they're practically taking their clothes off before they get
on stage. Everything has to happen like clockwork, okay? Someone standing by each delegate with a stopwatch making sure they all got the same amount of time.
Okay, and what happens if they're not ready? I mean, they're going to flog them in front of the whole audience. They're going to take the crown away,
crown. You have to be ready. You have 3 minutes to get out of your dress, stockings, high heels, into a swimsuit, new pair of high heels, not mess up your hair, and still look beautiful.
Oh, come on. They got to remember all that. They got to smile and remember that.
Mm-hmm.
It takes me 3 minutes just to put on my socks.
Ponder that, Tommy, while we return to the swimsuit competition.
I think I will.
Swimsuit.
Now, back to the action with Nevada.
Nevada's Gina Giacinto is currently on air as the weathercaster for KVNBC in Las Vegas. This former Radio City rockette also started FIT, an organization that talks to young people about body image and nutrition. While Tommy tries to beat the clock, get ready for a musical performance by international singing
Tommy.
Sensation Lara Fabian. And more bikinis.
Oh, wait, before we go on, I feel like I need a reality check. In the movie Miss Congeniality, I played the host of a beauty pageant. And now in the classic case of life imitating art, I am the host of Miss USA 2001. This is not a movie, this is real. Yes. I feel better now. Thank you. Let's continue. The swimsuit competition with Oregon.
Oregon's India Aberante studying psychology and journalism at the University of Oregon. She's the school's first person in 20 years to receive a Division I scholarship in track and field. India one day hopes to become a network news broadcaster.
One of the most important things about this competition is maintaining poise and appearing relaxed even if your name isn't called in the final 10. Oh, hi, excuse me. Mm-hmm. You've worked so hard to get here tonight. How did it feel not to be called in the top 10?
Well, you know, it's really not a big thing because it's really not about winning. This is all about being here and the friendships that I've had that are going to last for a lifetime. This experience has been so fulfilling for me and so wonderful.
Well, good luck to you.
Thank you so much.
How sweet.
Judges don't know. Hate their ass. Don't know nothing about no you.
We're right back here in the heat of the swimsuit competition round with District of Columbia.
District of Columbia's Leanne Angus is a graduate of George Washington University with a degree in exercise science and physiology. Currently a rehabilitation therapist and personal trainer, Leanne is also studying to be a certified American Sign Language interpreter. District of Columbia's Leanne Angus is a graduate of George Washington University with a degree in exercise science and physiology. Currently a rehabilitation therapist and personal trainer, Leanne is also studying to be a certified American Sign Language interpreter.
After spying on all the lovely delegates here, I've discovered some amazing secrets. So in case you ever want to compete in something like this, I've put together an essential, easy-to-use emergency beauty toolkit. Let's start. You got the needle and the thread. That's in case the gown starts coming off. A needle and a thread. Then you got your hemorrhoid cream. Don't trip. It's for those unsightly wrinkles under the eyes, but don't try it at home. And then there is the extra strength adhesive spray. Now, it helps keep the swimsuit in place so you don't get, you know, the wedgie crawling on up there. So you got to work.
But Tommy, oh, my, you're spoiling all the magic. Focus, man, focus.
My bad.
Goodness, we need to keep serious here because tonight we're seeing live competition in swimsuits and coming up, evening gowns. But in the past 2 weeks, delegates have competed in other areas that were equally critical. Check it out.
Yeah.
Where is the Iron Woman competition? You know what I'm saying? I want to see those girls pull some trucks with their teeth. Monster trucks. I want to see them hula hoop, do some mud wrestling. I want to see all that.
All right, Tommy, all right, you know. I think we need to introduce the next musical guest. She's okay. A singing sensation who continues to top the charts internationally.
Singing I Will Love Again, please show some love for Lara Fabian.
Did I ever tell you how you're living me? Every waking moment, even in my dreams. And if all the stuff sounds crazy, and you don't know what I mean, doesn't really matter. Just as long as I believe.
Coming up, more swimsuits and a musical performance by the Warren Brothers.
We're back at Miss USA 2001. If for some unexplained reason seeing beautiful women in swimsuits makes you feel uneasy, I advise you to look the other way now. Here is Texas.
Texas's Kandace Krueger is currently a senior at Texas A&M University studying journalism. When she's not writing, she's dancing and working out. Kandace describes herself as a sports fanatic and would love to have a career in sports broadcasting. Michigan. Michigan's Kenya Howard holds 2 degrees from Michigan State University, a master's in business and a bachelor's in engineering. Currently a mechanical engineer, Kenya is proud to have started a mentoring program for kids with academic and social difficulties.
That is one fine piece of headgear. Nice mockery. I wonder what else they get.
Well, Tommy, the woman who captures the crown this year will receive a bevy of fabulous prizes. First, Clairol's Natural Instincts awards Miss USA $5,000 and an assortment of products, including Natural Instincts Nourishing Hair Color, the only hair color enriched with 100% pure aloe, chamomile, and ginseng. Enlivens your natural color and leaves it healthier than before. Maurice Lacroix, Tomorrow's Classics, maker of fine Swiss timepieces, proudly presents Miss USA 2001 with a stunning diamond and steel watch from the Intuition Collection. Arome Dujardin, the official spa products for Miss USA 2001, proudly presents this year's winner with a $1,000 cash prize and a luxurious spa collection for the mind, body, and spirit. Sasha, the cosmetic choice of international women with exotic skin tones, once again proudly presents Miss USA 2001 with fine cosmetics and skincare products throughout her reign. Miss USA will be driving her sporty new 2001 convertible, a gift from the city of Gary.
Just so you're not confused, Tommy, the winner gets a real car.
Oh, and you know who look really good in those wheels, baby?
Me. Yeah, well, the only way you're going to win that car is to win the crown. And Tommy, I'm sorry, but I don't think that's going to happen.
Yeah, well, that's okay. This just isn't my year, but next year I'm going to do crunches.
Yeah, well, you can keep on dreaming, all right? And now the final delegate in the swimsuit competition. Can I get you to do some work around here? You'll
sure.
Say it with me?
All right.
Missouri.
Missouri's Larissa Meek has known from the age of 9 that she wanted to be an animator. She graduated from St. Louis Community College with a degree in animation and fine arts. Larissa has also set the goal of becoming a respected children's book author.
For this competition, As you've seen, they fine-tuned, fine-toned, and finessed just for this very night. Let's hear it for all the delegates. This USA 2001, the Swimsuit Odyssey.
All the delegates are wearing swimwear by pieces, provided by Bikini.com. Here are the scores.
I'm very proud of Gary, Indiana, and we're entering a period of unprecedented expansion. Miss USA is an important part of that. Gary, Indiana was a creature of the Industrial Revolution. Gary went from drawing boards in New York to reality here on the shores of Lake Michigan. It became an incredibly vibrant, diverse community, and our motto is a new city and a new century. Recapturing the city of Gary's downtown as the marketplace. We've brought in professional basketball. We're bringing in minor league baseball. Like any city, Gary's had good times, it's had bad times. Right now, I think we're stronger than ever and positioned to be investing and moving into our future.
The delegates gave me some fantastic advice. They said, if I stand at an angle to the judges, I'll look slimmer. How am I doing, judge? How am I doing? In this competition, learning the right way to walk is essential. So we flew in one of the hottest fashion model coaches from Paris, Jay Alexander. Now, for the first time, we'll take you into the backstage rehearsal rooms of Miss USA.
Miss Honey Cabbage, wait a minute, Miss Honey Lamb. Walking down catwalks is not so easy. You have to be visual.
He has better legs than I do. I mean, come on.
Take certain positions on the floor, and I'm going to go around and make sure I'm looking at you and help you work on the things that need to be corrected.
It's much more different than what I learned as a baby. I thought walking was easy, just one foot in front of the other, but it's actually the other way around.
Girls, where are your apples and where are your books? 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, slowly. Bravo.
Kind of makes us nervous sometimes. He's very conservative.
I'm satisfied when the girls are happy, when, you know, I see that something's changed. If it's not 100%, I'll accept 45.
I may have to give up walking. You can't imagine how I've been feeling up here, dressed in formal wear, while everyone else was in their swimsuit. Well, I was just about to change into my swimsuit, but wouldn't you know, the delegates have one-upped me and put on their evening gowns. Does that mean I should put mine on? To begin tonight's evening gown competition, here they are.
We'll be right back.
begin tonight's competition with Oklahoma. Tennessee. Nevada. Oregon. District of Columbia. Texas.
You just dance and come along.
Michigan. Missouri. Miss USA Evening Gown Competition.
That this is the 50th year of Miss USA.
Yeah, well, in preparing for tonight, I studied every Miss USA show in the history of Miss USA.
Every?
Every single one of them.
I think you probably studied every single one of the swimsuit competitions.
Well, that was the other night. But anyway, I've narrowed it down to three victory faces.
All right, three?
That's right, yeah.
All right, let's
There's the
see
face
them.
That says, I knew I was going to win mm-hmm. the whole time. There's the I can't believe that they picked a geek like me face.
This is my face.
And there's the I cannot believe this is the biggest night of my life. I hope I do not pee in my gown face.
Tommy, you got that one down to a T.
Here are the scores for the evening gown competition, and coming up, the final five, right here on CBS.
Countdown to Miss USA 2001 continues. The panel of judges have made their decisions, expressed their opinions, and exercised their rights. In my hand, their choices for the final five. And here they are, as always, in random order. Number one, Nevada. The next we have Missouri. Step forward, Texas. Our fourth finalist, District of Columbia. And rounding out our five, Georgia. present to you the top five finalists. We're about to go into the complicated psyches of our remaining delegates. But before we do, let's check in with someone who lived through a night like this and is here to tell. Vanessa.
You're probably watching this thinking, okay, they all look good, but do they have anything going on up here? If you went to dinner with one of these girls, would they have anything interesting to say? Well, that's sort of what the next competition is all about. Now, the hard part is you never know what kind of question will be thrown at you. It could be anything, but hey, no one said it would be easy. The delegates have spent many sleepless nights around the clock just trying to prepare. Check it out.
What is the atomic weight of argon, and how many isotopes does it have?
18, with 8 isotopes.
What's the biggest problem facing the country today?
What?
What's the biggest problem facing the country today?
The biggest what?
Problem.
Do you have a problem?
The calvarium, the temporal bone, the sphenoid sinus, and the lower mandible.
What is the biggest problem facing the country today?
You have a problem? Is it your boyfriend again?
No.
What's your favorite food?
Oh, pizza.
Facing the country today.
What country?
Our country.
Where?
Here.
What?
Problem.
And that's why I identify most with the great Eleanor Roosevelt, Mr. Shatner. How's that?
Awesome.
Now to spread some love, I'd like to send a message to all the delegates not in the top five. You know what I mean? Even though you didn't make the final cut, just remember you're a winner no matter what. Y'all will be sisters, all right, yeah. Cause tonight is all about having fun. See, in a way, you all have already won. So I'm gonna put this in a beat. Go! Just trying to keep things hip, that's all. Now, if you thought that was good, I want you to introduce our next artist, country artists, and they're bad too. Can we do it all together? Let's give it up for the Warren Brothers.
We're wasting all our time and energy, it seems, submitting our broken hearts as if they were machines. There ain't a tool around that can make us tight. Hell, I don't know where all the good times went. Had a pocket full of love, now there ain't nothing left but lint. A handful of good times don't make it right. Cause I don't wanna leave. I got one foot out the door, got one foot in my mouth. We're always saying things that we don't really mean, like I love you and I'll be with you for all eternity. We don't have that long to work this out. Pieces don't fit, there ain't nothing you can do.
find the answers. And I've read all the books, watched all the daytime shows. But sometimes we're the victims, sometimes we're the crooks. That's just the way it goes.
Coming up, questions, questions, and more questions. And hopefully the top five will have the right answers here on CBS.
No matter what lengths these delegates have gone through to prepare, this is definitely the part of the competition where stress levels go up, way up, especially mine. It's best to remain calm, dignified, don't ramble, and just be yourself. If that doesn't work, just make it up and keep smiling. The delegates will randomly pick the name of one of the judges. Okay, Nevada, please come over here and pick out one of the judges' names for your questions. Ed, the judge is Ananda Lewis.
Hello.
Hi. Your first question is, have you ever used your looks or charm to avoid getting a ticket?
Well, actually I have. I blamed it on a sneeze and it actually worked.
Yes. Like that. Does money buy justice?
In the entertainment industry, I think sometimes it does, and I don't think it's fair because we need to hold those people up to high standards.
And lastly, in a courtroom, are celebrities at an advantage or a disadvantage?
An advantage, and I don't think that that's fair. I think everybody needs to be able to go by the same rules and regulations, and it's time that they do.
Thank you very much, Nevada.
Thank you. Would you take your place on the scoring disc, please? Missouri, please reach in and pick out one of the judges' names for your question. And your judge is Danny Baldwin.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Is the media's need for controversy bad for sports?
Media's need for controversy in sports. I guess, can you explain what you mean as controversy in particular sport?
I could just read the question.
Okay,
is the media's need for controversy bad for sports?
Well, I think there is a lot of controversy in sports as being role models, and I think holding them to the higher standard that they are, that I think the media shouldn't... Here we go.
Let me ask the second question.
Okay, thank you.
What female athlete do you admire the most?
Actually, I'm not a big sports person, so it's very difficult for me to answer that question because I'm an art major and I'm an artist. And honestly, I'm not a big sports fanatic. But my favorite female sport player, I can't honestly answer that because I don't watch much sports.
Thank you very much. Would you take your place on the scoring disc, please? Texas, please reach in and pick out one of the judges' names for your question. Thank you. Doris Roberts.
Is there an inherent friction between mothers and daughters?
I think there is, but I think it's wonderful. My mother and I have had a friction at times, but it's been great, and we're the best of friends, and she's up there rooting for me. Hi, Mom.
All right. Has there ever been an occasion when you had to admit to your mother that she was right? And if so, when?
Absolutely. Lots of occasions, unfortunately. The most recent probably refers back to the speeding tickets. She's always telling me to slow down, and I can't tell you how many. Well, she doesn't know. I've gotten 3 tickets in the last year.
Okay. Can you do an impression of your mother?
Yes, but I can just use my eyes. She's an eyes person. That's all you need to see is the eyes, and you know she's mad.
Okay. Thank you very much. Take your position on the scoring chart, please. District of Columbia, please reach in and pick out one of the judges. Don't look, you've got it. And your judge is Ernie Hudson.
Is more rigorous testing the best way to improve our educational system?
I believe so. I believe that when you are challenged, you tend to rise up and meet that challenge. So I definitely believe that, yes.
Okay. What weren't you taught in school that you wish you had learned?
I would probably have to say how to speak slowly. I have a hard time sometimes speaking very fast. So if I could just articulate and speak very slowly, that's probably one of the things that I would probably do.
And who's the best teacher you ever had?
My best teacher would be my piano teacher. I love her to pieces. It was Candy Jefferson, and she literally changed my life. I play piano, and I love it, and it's helped give me discipline in my life.
Thank you very much. Would you please take your position on the scoring disc? Georgia, please reach in and pick out one of the judges' names for your question. It is Martha Stewart.
Oh, Miss Martha!
Do we too often confuse celebrity with achievement?
I think it's very easy to combine the both, and we look to celebrities as role models sometimes, and I think as parents we need to step back and prove to our children and educate the children to let them know that we ourselves as families should be role models, not so much celebrities or basketball players or football players.
Is the media to blame for the emphasis on winning at all costs?
I think in the recent years, I think it's getting that way. All the hype surrounds the Super Bowl or the NBA championships. It's getting to the point where it's win at all cost. I hope it's not like this with the pageant, but...
Who's an effective role model for young girls today?
Thank you very much. Your time is up. Would you take your place on the scoring disc?
Women.
What if you're up there and they ask a question and you go blank and you just stand there in front of millions of people just going like,
"You're right."
Vanessa, now you've gone through this.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, when they ask a tough question, I mean, how does it feel? I mean,
well, you know what? I know it sounds like such a cliche, but it all comes down to just being yourself, believe it or not. Just what comes first to your heart, what comes first to your mind, and if you try to answer it right, that's when you're sunk. So.
I hear that. Well, no matter what happens, no matter what, the winner is going to have to do the victory scream. You know that.
I know that.
find out who is going to do the victory scream. Coming up, final three.
We had 51, then 10, 5. Now here they are, the final three. First, District of Columbus. Next, Texas. And finally, Georgia. There they are, the three finalists for Miss USA 2001.
You can just feel the tension out there, not only from the delegates, but also from the judges. I don't know how you guys do this. I don't know how y'all do this. I don't know how y'all do it.
Well, you know, the delegates are also up for another award, the title of Miss Congeniality. Now, the judges are off the hook for this one because this is the only award that the delegates actually choose themselves.
Now, Miss Congeniality, what's that about? You just got to be nice to everybody? What's up?
Trust me, it's not as easy as it looks.
Well, it's really not a competition. We're really here to root each other on and help each other out whenever we can.
Okay, honey, I'm ready to go on stage. How do I look? Is my hair okay? Do I have anything in my teeth?
No, you are good.
Thank you.
Go get 'em.
We push each other to be better than we would be on our own.
I don't think I can hold this anymore.
Oh, sure you can. I know you can do it.
Hello? Hi. Do you mind? I am on the phone.
All the delegates have been so sweet, especially Miss Texas. She is such a doll.
Okay, good luck.
Break a leg.
Thanks.
I mean, really break a leg.
Oh, now, see, I get that. See, in my world, that's kind of the way stand-up comedians act. You know, they're real supportive, behind your back, and then as soon as you turn around...
It's about time I'm up here by myself.
Coming up, find out who will really get their hands on the crown.
Miss USA celebrates women who want to make a difference. Here's a story of a woman in Gary who has.
The children give me great joy, and to see them shine, to grow so far as their character is concerned, that's very important to me and to them.
For over 30 years, Jeanette Cowan has been inspiring her students. As music director at the Emerson School for Visual and Performing Arts in the city of Gary, her students learn about music and a whole lot more.
The most important thing Ms. Cowan has taught me is discipline.
Discipline. Strict discipline.
They're still kids, but when they hit the stage, you see discipline and professionalism because I teach them that they represent more than themselves. Their home, their city, and their diplomats. And that's for certain.
Welcome back. Follow this logic, if you will. The recipients of the two awards that we will hand out will also win the Hoya Crystal Trophy. So first, the Miss Congeniality Award. The 51 delegates have cast their vote and spoken. The winner of the 2001 Miss Congeniality is North Carolina. For the next award, Clairol held a special competition earlier this week. Let's take a look. The Clairol Natural Instinct Style Award goes to the delegate with the best overall presentation of personal style with an emphasis on healthy hair. Oh, I get it. It's really the best hair award is what it is. The winner of the Clairol Natural Instinct Style Awards is Marilyn.
Martha, Martha Stewart, that is you. We have lost the crown. You gotta bail us out. You know how to make things. You gotta help us out.
Don't worry about it. I have it under control. All you'll need is some potpourri.
Potpourri.
Two lobster forks, believe it or not. And maybe one or two bay leaves. And voila, the crown.
I like this. You saved the show.
It's a good thing.
I'm liking this.
The top three delegates will now be asked a question by someone that's been overseeing tonight's proceedings, me. Each finalist is given the opportunity to answer the same question in her own unique and hopefully memorable way. Texas and Georgia, please step over to the listening station and put on the earphones so you don't hear the question. Okay? They're making their way. Let's test it. We'll test it as soon as they put the earphones on. And the earphones are on. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? No, they can't hear me. Okay. Here's your question. District of Columbia. Many things that were once science fiction are now science fact. Some scientists believe they can clone human beings, should we?
Cloning is a very interesting thing because it's a marvel. The ability to clone is just absolutely wonderful, but we have to understand that cloning is something that pushes human beings. Human beings always want to push limits, and they always want to push the envelope. And I agree with cloning of organs, but cloning of human beings I don't agree with. Thank you.
Thank you very much, District of Columbia. Would you go up and take your place at the station, please? Texas, your question. Many things that were once science fiction are now science fact. Some scientists believe they can clone human beings. Should we?
Absolutely not. I believe that everything happens for a reason, and I've actually done a lot of reading about cloning here lately. It's been in the news quite a bit. And I have faith that everything happens for a reason. A lot of people are wanting to clone children because they've lost a child. And again, like I said, I think everything happens for a reason, and I think that's something that, a boundary that we should not cross.
Thank you very much. Would you take your place up there, please? Georgia, here's your question. Many things that were once science fiction are now science fact. Some scientists believe they can clone human beings. Should we?
No. I think it's totally wrong. We're going way beyond nature. We're going on to way far beyond limits that we should even step into. And it's unethical. And we should consider going back to more simpler times and maybe concentrating on just being one and not worrying about so many others.
Thank you very much. Would you take your place up there, please? And now, once again, the top three delegates for Miss USA.
District of Columbia.
Texas.
Georgia. We'll be right back with the one that captures the crowd.
Yes, never in a million years could we have done Miss USA 2001 without the help of a few people that we'd like to give a big thanks to right now. The mayor of Gary, Indiana, the Honorable Scott L. King. President of the Gary Common Council, Councilman-at-Large Roy Pratt. Chair of the Executive Host City Committee, Deputy Mayor Suzette Rags. And the co-owner, along with CBS, of the Miss Universe organization, Donald Trump. And now, last year's Miss USA, Lynnette Cole, let's hear her thoughts as she takes her final walk as Miss USA.
Being crowned Miss USA last February was a lifelong dream come true. Throughout this year, I have had the pleasure to work with various charities, including the Carolyn Baldwin Breast Cancer Research Fund, the Ovarian Cancer Research Fund, and the Gildas Club. But my greatest personal accomplishment has been the adoption advocacy work I've been so fortunate to be involved in. I am grateful and humbled by these experiences. I am not only taking with me many of life's lessons, but many friends as well. Ashley, Susie, Emily, and Lauren, thank you for all your encouragement throughout this year. To my parents, family, and Kim Greenwood, I love you all dearly. I could not have achieved this dream without you. Finally, to all my friends and family in Columbia, Tennessee, thank you for all your love and support you have shown me this past year. I will always hold these memories as a gift close to my heart.
And now, little Mark Ward of the accounting firm of Ernst & Young is handing me the name of the woman who will win the crown of Miss USA 2001. We will begin with the second runner-up, Georgia. Ladies, please join me in the winner's circle down here. If for any reason the new Miss USA can't fulfill her duties, the first runner-up will take over. The first runner-up is District of Columbia. That means the new Miss USA is Texas. To Tommy Davidson, Vanessa Manillo, Lara Dutta, the Warren Brothers, Lara Fabian, Avon and Jared, and to Gary, Indiana, good night!
Good night!
Good night, Gary, Indiana!